Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhaevacha Patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadara Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're recounting the pastimes of a cowherd boy from Vrindavan who, by the power of the mantra given to his guru, was able to go to the spiritual world.
我们在讲述来自于文达伦高尔丹山的一位牧牛童的消失光，他的guru给了他一首mantra，帮他一搜这种mantra，甚至旅行到了灵性的世界。And
he was able to go into the spiritual world, into Goloka Vrindavan.
他甚至去了灵性世界，来到了Goloka Vrindavan.
And at this point, we're hearing how Gop Kumar is with Krishna and they're in Goloka Vrindavan, and Krishna and the cowherd boy from Vrindavan, his name was Gop Kumar, but in the spiritual world, Krishna told him his name is actually Sarat.
他们在格洛克文达伦，他在地球上的名字叫Gopakumar，但是来到灵性世界之后，Krishna告诉他他的名字叫Sarup。Sarat。And
Krishna invited this cowherd boy to take his food with him, to come and take their meal together.
Krishna 就邀请这个牧牛童 跟他们一起进餐.
And the gopis are there serving Krishna.
那里有很多的牧牛姑娘在服务 Krishna.
So Krishna, it's not that Krishna wants to take service from the gopis, but he wants, but he wants to satisfy the desires of the gopis, and that's his Krishna's real wish. He doesn't like that the gopis just serve him. He doesn't demand that they serve him, but he wants to fulfill their desires.
Krishna并不是 强求着要牧牛姑娘们服务他，而是他喜欢满足这些牧牛姑娘想要服务他的心愿.
And there are different gopis there, there's several gopis there, and Krishna reciprocates with them all differently, each of them individually. He doesn't let the other gopis know how he's dealing with each particular gopi.
在场的有几位不同的gopi在服务他， Krishna 是以不同的方式来回应他们，因为他们都是个体的，所以Krishna呢也不希望让别的人知道他是怎么样的来单独回应这些牧牛姑娘的。
So Krishna pleased all his different gopis with his behavior, and he also had special talks with one special gopi named Sri Radhika.
Krishna 就取悦了这些不同牧牛姑娘的举止, 在场的有一位特殊的勾皮，她名字叫 Radhika。
Because she's actually the chief of all the gopis, and Krishna took special pleasure to talk to her.
她实际上是所有牧牛姑娘的首领， Krishna 特别喜欢跟她交谈。
So then Krishna decides he wants to have a little rest. So all the gopis understand that it's time for them to leave, and they go for their own homes.
Krishna 决定休息，所有的 gopi 们呢，他们就明白该离开了，所以就回到各自的家中。
So even though the gopis were leaving Krishna, they were happy because they knew that secretly they're going to meet Krishna later.
虽然牧牛姑娘们将要离开 Krishna, 但是他们内心是愉悦的，因为他们，在心底里知道他们还会再次相聚。
So another cowherd boy is there, one of Krishna's friends. His name is Sridham, and he came. And he brought Gop Kumar, his other name is Sarat, he brought Gop Kumar with him to his house because Krishna is going to take rest. So Sridham and Gop Kumar, they go to Sridham's house.
在场的有另外一个牧牛童，名字叫 Sridham， 因为 Krishna 要休息了，所以 Sridham 就带着 Sarat回自己的家，让 Krishna 休息。
Yeah, you're right. The name is not Sarad, it's Sarup. Yeah. You got the name right, Guru Mani. Sarup. Yeah, Sarup is the name of the cowherd boy, right? Sarup. So Sarup will be worried about, he will be curious about Krishna's pastime, about what Krishna's pastime is going to be with the gopis.
So Sarup, 他就很好奇，想知道 Krishna 跟这些牧牛姑娘之间发生的小时光。
But that is not the business of the cowherd boys. That's Krishna's own business with the gopis. Whatever Krishna does at night with the gopis, that's only Krishna's concern. It's nothing to do with the cowherd boys.
但是 Krishna 和牧牛姑娘之间，他们要做的事情并不关这些牧牛童的事情，这是 Krishna 应该关心的事情，他和牧牛姑娘之间他们晚上该怎么过。
So that night Sarup stayed awake all night, and he was in great distress, and early in the morning he went to the home of Krishna, went to the home of Nanda Maharaj, and he saw Krishna asleep in bed.
所以 Sarup 他就一夜未眠，因为他内心里因为跟 Krishna 分开了，所以很难过。第二天清晨他就去了 Nanda 大君的家里头，他发现 Krishna 还在床上。
And he was surprised when he went to see Krishna sleeping in his bed. He could see there were scratches all over Krishna's body, scratches which had been made by someone's fingernails.
Sarup 他就很惊讶地看见躺在床上的 Krishna, 他的身上有些指甲的划痕，是某些人的手指甲划出来的印记。
So while Krishna is laying on his bed sleeping, Krishna's mother, Mother Yashoda, comes in and she sits down at his side, and she's saying something, but she's saying something under her breath because she could see the marks on Krishna's body.
所以当 Krishna 就躺在床上的时候呢，亚瑟的妈妈就进了房间，就坐在了床榻边上，然后他就低声的喃喃自语，他看见 Krishna 身上的这些划痕。
But Mother Yashoda is a simple lady. She's very simple and straightforward. And she could not understand. She was not able to understand what it could have caused all the marks on Krishna's body.
Yashoda's mother is a simple, simple, and straightforward woman in the village. 虽然他不明白，就是 Krishna 身上的这些印记到底是怎么回事。
She just came there to bathe Krishna and to get him ready for the day because Krishna is going to go out with the boy, the cowherd boys, so she has to get him ready.
亚瑟的妈妈进屋是来给 Krishna 沐浴的，因为 Krishna 清晨要和其他的牧牛童一起外出。
So Mother Yashoda is speaking to Krishna. She's saying, oh, my little boy spends the day in the forest taking care of the cows. He's so tired.
Yashoda 就对 Krishna 说，oh, 我的孩子，我的小儿子，你在外面一整天都要照料这些母牛，你一定很累了。
And he was so happy to go to sleep, and now he doesn't want to wake up. Of course, Krishna had been awake all night dancing with the gopis, but Mother Yashoda didn't know this.
晚上 Krishna 是跟勾皮们跳了一夜的舞，所以亚瑟的妈妈她对此一无所知。
So she just thought he's still asleep because he's just a little boy and he needs more rest.
她以为 Krishna 是一个小男孩而已，他只是需要更多的睡眠。
And she thought the scratches on his body must be from the thorns when he's running around in the forest.Sometimes thorns will be there, which may scratch you.
他心想，这些 Krishna 这个皮肤上的划痕，一定是他白天跑来跑去被荆棘所划破的。
But when she examined and touched the marks on Krishna's body, she wondered, how could thorns in the forest have cut his lips?
可是当他检查 Krishna 身上的这些划痕的时候，他很纳闷，这些荆棘怎么会刺伤 Krishna 的嘴唇呢？
And she thought, oh, he must have been running, and then he fell into the bush, and the bush scratched his face.
一定是他跑的时候，一下子跌倒在地上，就倒在了荆棘上面，他的嘴唇也被荆棘划伤了。
Must have been very painful for him, and now he's fast asleep.
他一定感觉很疼，他现在睡得多么香甜啊！
He's not aware of anything, and the kajala from his eyes is all over his body. The ointment which he puts on his eyes is all over his body.
他甚至，他现在都睡得这么沉，以至于他什么都不知道。他眼上的卡扎眼膏，现在都在他身上弄得到处都是。
Actually, that ointment, that kajala, this black stuff, this is from the gopis' eyes.
实际上，这些卡扎这个黑眼膏是来自于勾皮。眼睛上的眼膏。
Because Krishna had been embracing the gopis, so it's all over his body.
Krishna 在夜里跟牧牛姑娘拥抱，所以 Kaja 也沾到了他的身上。
And then he doesn't, Krishna doesn't know that he spilled the red pan juice from his lips all over himself.
Krishna 也不知道，那些槟榔汁也在他身上留下了很多的印记。
And because he tosses and turns in the bed, he's broken his necklace and garlands and other ointments. They're all broken.
因为 Krishna 躺在床上的时候，会在床上辗转辗转。来回的翻滚，所以呢，他脖子上的项链，以他身上的花环，还有那些装饰物呢，现在都散落了。
Yeah, they're broke because he was embracing the gopis.
他们之所以断落，是由于他在夜里拥抱牧牛姑娘的缘故。
And the red stain of the pan which is on Krishna, this is from the gopis also.
他身上留下的，因为槟榔汁，红色的槟榔汁也是来自于勾皮的。
But Mother Yashoda, she doesn't think any, she can't believe anything like this. She's only thinking Krishna's a little boy, he's my little son.
但是亚修的妈妈，她没有考虑这一些，她也不去相信，她只是想，我的小儿子他还那么小。
And Krishna's got this saffron-colored clay all over his body. And it seems that even when he takes a bath, it won't rub off.
Krishna 身上呢，也浑身上下都有那些橘红色的泥土的印记，而且好像是他沐浴也没有把它们弄下来。
Mother Yashoda thought this was the clay from the bank of the Yamuna, but actually it was the kumkum from the gopis' chests.
Yashoda 妈妈以为这些印记是来自亚穆纳河的泥土，但事实上呢，他们是因为牧牛姑娘胸上的kumkum粉而沾在了她的身上。
And Mother Yashoda said, it must have been last night, those gopis, they were bathing Krishna and they didn't bathe him properly.
Yashoda 妈妈心想，昨天傍晚，这些牧牛姑娘给 Krishna 沐浴，都没有给他们好好的沐浴。
I let these gopis bathe Krishna, they didn't do it carefully. If they'd done it properly, all the dirt would have come off.
这些牧牛姑娘昨天，这些小姑娘，她们没有好好的给她沐浴。如果她们好好的沐浴了的话，这些粉都会掉下来的。
Yeah, they didn't put the. They're supposed to put oil and then put the oil on, and then the oil will bring off what's on the body. But they didn't put the oil on properly, so they didn't clean Krishna properly.
他们本来是，他们应该是在 Krishna 身上先涂上油，这些油呢就会把他身上的这些，橘黄色的粉印记呢给他给抹下来，所以他现在留在那里，一定是这些姑娘们没有很好的给他们沐浴。
So then, while Mother Yashoda is like this, at that time the gopis begin to come.The young gopis all started to arrive at Krishna's house.
Yashoda 妈妈这样想的时候，年轻的那些牧牛姑娘就纷纷的来到了她的家中。
And some are laughing, and some are embarrassed, and some are afraid.
有些小姑娘呢，她们在欢笑着进来，而有些呢，很害羞的进来，还有的呢，就怀着一些害怕的表情走了进来。
So just when Mother Yashoda was complaining about Krishna's condition, about all the state, how his garlands are broken and he's still got this red marks on him and everything, at that time the gopis all came.And they could hear Mother Yashoda So some they would become a bit afraid because she was blaming them.
亚瑟的妈妈她在抱怨着 Krishna 身上的这些各种各样的印记的时候，那些 Gopi 的他们走了进来，能够听见她低声的抱怨声，所以呢，有一些呢就害怕亚瑟的妈妈会责备他们。
She thought, the gopis thought, maybe Mother Yashoda knows that, or she'll find out that Krishna had been going at night to be with the gopis, and they'd been dancing together in the forest.
These gopis 们就担心亚瑟的妈妈，也许她已经知道了，或者是发觉 Krishna 在夜里头跟那些牧牛姑娘大跳 Rasa 之舞。
And so some of them were laughing at Mother Yashoda because she was so naive, she didn't understand, she didn't think anything bad, anything that Krishna was doing anything.
有些牧牛姑娘之所以发笑，她是因为亚瑟的妈妈那么天真，她不知道，也不明白 Krishna 晚上所做的事情。
But some gopis are embarrassed because they can see that it's so obvious that Krishna had been with the gopis in the night. So they feel ashamed, they feel embarrassed that Mother Yashoda will discover them.
有些牧牛姑娘都感觉很不好意思、害臊，因为这 Krishna 身上的这些印记显而易见表明了 Krishna。
So Krishna wakes up from his sleep and Mother Yashoda gives him a bath and then dresses him and then she feeds Krishna along with Balaram.
Krishna 醒了过来，然后亚瑟的妈妈为他沐浴，给他和 Balarama 一起食，给他们食物吃。
So after taking some food, Mother Yashoda lets Krishna take a little, lets him relax for a little while and let him talk with the gopis. And then she gets ready for Krishna to go into the forest.
给 Krishna 食物之后，亚瑟的妈妈让 Krishna 稍微的放松一些，和 gopi 们轻松的交谈之后，就准备让 Krishna 去森林。
And Mother Yashoda then gets the gopis to sing songs for Krishna's good fortune, to bless Krishna, and she gets them to carry food pots and different auspicious things to make it auspicious for Krishna going into the forest.
亚瑟的妈妈就让牧牛姑娘，为了让她的儿子去森林这件事情是一切都是吉祥的，也能得到祝福。亚瑟的妈妈就让这些牧牛姑娘头顶着一整罐的各种各样的吉祥的物品，好为 Krishna 去森林这件事情呢，让他一切都显得那么吉祥。
Yeah, and in the Vedic culture, there are different.Things which you carry to make everything auspicious.
按照北达文化，就是人会拖着各种各样的物品，就是让这个事件和氛围是一种吉祥的氛围。
If a bucket is empty, that's not good. That's inauspicious. But if it's full with water and some yogurt and flowers, that's auspicious.
如果这个瓦罐或者是这个木桶是空空的，那就表明是不吉祥的。如果这个瓦罐里就盛满了水、酸奶或者是花、鲜花的话，那就表明是吉祥的。
But the thought of Krishna going into the forest is very painful for the young gopis. They're going to be separated from Krishna for the day.
一想到 Krishna 要去森林一整天。这些年轻的牧牛姑娘都因为跟 Krishna 即将分离，感到非内心痛苦万分。
So Mother Yashoda gets Krishna to sit on a chair with Balaram, and she puts different ornaments and medicinal herbs on Krishna.
Yashoda Mama 就让 Krishna 和 Balarama 一起坐在椅子上，就给开始为他们穿扮，上各种各样的装饰物，并且给他们用这些森林里的药草来装饰他们。
Yeah, Mother Yashoda has many different items which are for Krishna's protection and to make his time in the forest will be protected by wearing these different things. Things like a tiger nail and different kinds of threads which she wraps around his wrist and around his ankles.
Yashoda Mama 有各种各样的保护的神器，可以让 Krishna 在森林里能够得到安然无恙。比如说有老虎的指甲，或者是各种各样的线，佩戴在他们身上，在他们的腰间，或者是在他们的脚踝上佩戴上，好保护他们。
And she gives a special stone, an emerald, which will protect him against any poison.
他还为他们佩戴上特殊的宝石，红宝石，好让他们免百毒不侵。
And special herbs which will heal any wound if it gets any wound when they're walking in the forest. They have special herbs to put on it to protect it, to heal the wound.
假设他们在森林行走的时候弄伤了自己。也是妈妈为了防止他们弄伤自己，也给他们身上涂上了这些特殊的药液来保护他们，让这些伤口好尽快的愈合。
Mother Yashoda also gets the elderly Brahmin ladies to offer blessings to Krishna and Balaram.
亚瑟的妈妈也让也邀请年长的Brahmani 婆罗门女士来祝福了 Krishna 和 Balarama.
But Mother Yashoda also wants Krishna to do different rituals before he goes into the forest, which will protect him, which will be good for him.
Yashoda 妈妈还让 Krishna 来举行各种各样的仪式。好让他在森林当中呢，能得到保护。
Krishna just wants to go to the forest. He doesn't want to do all of these things. But Mother Yashoda insists, no, you have to do these.
Krishna 只想赶紧去森林，他不想做这些仪式。但是在亚瑟的妈妈的坚持之下呢，亚瑟的妈妈说，你必须得这么去做。
So then Krishna took his lunch, because he has to take his lunch with him for the midday. Mother Yashoda prepared the lunch that he can carry with him. And Krishna wakes up, gets the cows ready and gets them to set off. And Krishna starts playing his flute.
所以亚瑟的妈妈就给他带上了他的午餐，Krishna 呢就去牛圈把那些母牛们唤醒，就准备好要朝森林进发了。Krishna 这时候就吹起了笛子。
But just at that time, his companions came. All the cowherd boys, they came in groups from the cowherd village, and they gathered there. The boys were all his very close friends.
就在此时，就从村子里走出了 Krishna 最好的、最亲密的那些牧牛童朋友们，他们都加入了 Krishna.
Because Krishna had played the flute. So as soon as they heard the flute, all the boys, they came running, and they're very eager to be with Krishna. They have great love for Krishna.
一听到 Krishna 吹起了笛子，这些牧牛童因为对 Krishna 的爱，就遵从家中就奔了出来。They
didn't worry even if they hadn't finished taking their breakfast. They just heard that Krishna's ready and he's going to the forest, and they want to go with Krishna.
有些人甚至还没有吃完早餐，但是他们一听到 Krishna 已经走出了家门，他们就纷纷的。
So there were many boys, and they put themselves into groups, and in each group there would be some kind of leader of the group. Some boy would be more prominent than the others.
有那么多的牧牛童，所以呢，他们会分成不同的小组，有一些会担当组长。
But all the boys, all the cowherd boys, they were all good. They were all very fit, qualified to be very close friends with Krishna. And so some boy would play his flute, another boy would play buffalo horn, another boy has an instrument made from leaves which he would play. So they could use these different things to make instruments. They would pick up special leaves and grass, and they could make sounds out of them, like music.
他们会利用各种各样的，比如说叶子啊，或者是捡起地上的草，把它们做成乐器来吹。
So Krishna is standing with his brother and all the cowherd boys, and they're all happy, joyfully singing and dancing and glorifying Krishna.
Krishna就和他的哥哥站在前面，其他的男孩子们。
So every day they would carry things with them because they're going to the forest for the day. So they would bring their food and bring their drink, and they would bring also, some would carry umbrellas, and some had wooden shoes, and some had drums, and some had flags and fans.
他们都手中拿着各种各样的饰物，因为他们在森林当中要去一整天，所以呢，有的人呢拿着食物，他们带着各自的食物饮料，有的拿着伞，还有着带着木屐，有的呢拿着鼓，还有的拿着旗帜，有的拿着这些山粮用的。
Yeah, because they're going, so they're going in the forest, so they bring different things for their games. They play in the forest, they have different games which they play, so they bring everything with them for their playing in the forest. So they're very happy to go there, to get away from their home. Because when they're away from their home, they can play as they like. When they're at home, the mother and father will tell them, don't do this, don't do that. But when they're in the forest, they play as they like.
因为他们一旦去了森林，就可以随心所欲的尽情的玩耍。如果在家里头，父亲和妈妈、爸爸就会告诉他们，你不要这样做，要那么做。但是在森林里，他们就可以无拘无束的玩耍。
So Krishna's brother, elder brother Balaram walks in front, and Gop Kumar, Sarup, he walks behind. And the girls, the gopis are all watching, feeling pain to be separated from Krishna.
Krishna's 哥哥 Balarama 走在队伍的最前列。Gop Kumar 他现在是 Sarup， 他就跟在后面。那些牧牛姑娘，那些女孩子们，因为要跟 Krishna 分开一整天，内心都很难过。
And the gopis would find excuses. They'd try to follow, and they'd come out from their villages. They'd try to follow because they felt so much love for Krishna.
牧牛姑娘们就找出了各种各样的理由，在后面跟着这个队伍。他们也走出了村子，他们内心怀着对 Krishna 深深的爱意。
So Gop Kumar, the cowherd boy, he's in friendship with Krishna, but he knows the gopis' love for Krishna is also very. It's he knows the gopis have so much love for Krishna. He doesn't like to mention it because it would cause him also. It would put him in ecstasy. It would disturb his mind just to think about.The relationship Krishna has with the gopis.
Gopa Kumar, 和 Krishna 之间是朋友的关系，他没有提及gopi 们和 Krishna 的关系，因为如果他要是提及这些关系的话，他自己也会陷入狂喜，他的心意呢就会受到骚扰。
And the gopis, they're not supposed to show their attraction for Krishna in the broad daylight in front of everyone. But they did it. They came out and they followed Krishna because they just couldn't control their feelings for him.
牧牛姑娘们呢，她们是不应该在光天化日之下来展示她 Krishna.对他们深深的吸引的，但是他们无法控制自己的感情，所以他们都尾随在 Krishna 后面。
And even Krishna, seeing all the gopis and feeling his love for them, Krishna begins to perspire, and his face is all sweating. And Mother Yashoda comes and wipes his face.
Krishna 看见牧牛姑娘们。对他的深情厚爱，他感到非常激动，他都流出了汗。然后亚瑟的妈妈就过来为他擦拭他的汗。
And Mother Yashoda follows Krishna out to the outer gate of the village, and Mother Yashoda, she's feeling so much love for Krishna that her breasts are wet with the milk.
亚瑟的妈妈就尾随着 Krishna。也走到了村子的外面的大门，他对因为出于对 Krishna 的爱，他的衣服都被他的母乳而打湿了。
So then Krishna tells Mother Yashoda, "You should go back. Better you go home." But after two or three steps.She went back. She turned. She took Krishna's request and went. Stopped following him and went home.
Krishna 告诉亚修的，让他回家。但是亚修的走了两三步之后，又转过身来，跟着走了几步。之后呢，他就又转回身。
So she knows Krishna likes pan, so she put some pan before she left Krishna. First of all, she put some pan in his mouth, and then she gave him some more pan in his hand that he could chew later on. And then she went back home.
雅士的妈妈知道 Krishna 喜欢吃槟榔, 所以她就, 在离开 Krishna 之前呢, 就往她的嘴里, 放了几颗槟榔, 又在她的手里 塞了几个槟榔, 然后她就朝, 朝家的方向走回去。
But then when she's going, she comes back again. She can't leave Krishna. She comes back to him. She's unable to separate herself from him.
走了几步之后, 她又返回身, 因为她无法跟Krishna分开。
And then this time she starts feeding Krishna some fruit and some other sweets and give him something to drink.
这一次她回来给Krishna吃了一些水果和甜点, 还给她喝了一些饮品。
And then again, okay, she's going home. But then when she's going home again, she comes back. She can't leave Krishna.
做完这之后呢,她又朝家的方向走过去。走了没两步,她又转过身,又回来了,因为她离不开Krishna。
So this time she comes back and she looks over Krishna and she straightens his clothes and adjusts everything he's wearing, makes sure everything is looking very nice. And then she's going to go back, but again she comes back. And this time she comes back and she gives Krishna some instructions.
然后亚瑟的妈妈就看着Krishna,就把他的衣服拽直, 又把他身上的这个饰物呢,又给他整理了一下, 让Krishna看上去特别的英俊潇洒, 然后他就又朝家的方向转过身,准备回家, 走了没两步,他又转过身,又回来了, 这一次呢,他准备给Krishna一些训示。
So Krishna is a naughty child. Mother Yashoda knows he's naughty, and she knows that Krishna probably won't pay attention to whatever she says. But still she tries to give him instruction. So she tells Krishna, don't go too far into the forest. Some regions of the forest are very thick and difficult to penetrate. Don't you go in there.
他告诉Krishna, 不要在森林里走太远, 有些林子, 非常的, 有些森林呢, 它是非常浓密的, 你们根本无法穿越这些森林。
And if there are thorns there, also you shouldn't go there because you'll ruin your feet, you'll get all scratched and cut. So don't go if there are thorns.
如果路上有一些有荆棘密布的地方, 就千万不要过去, 不然的话, 你的脚就会被这些荆棘划伤刺破。
So Mother, you spoke. Mother Yashoda spoke for quite a long time, telling Krishna to take care, and then she said, okay, I'm going home now, but then when she was going, she came back again.
Yashoda妈妈就跟Krishna说了很长时间的话,然后她希望Krishna能把这些话都听到心里头,之后等她说完,Yashoda妈妈, 这时候呢,又准备回家,返回家里头,但是呢,他走了两步,他又回来了。
And this time she says, okay, Rama, Balarama, that you stay in front of Krishna. And Sridham, you stay behind with your friend Sarup. you stay behind Krishna. So Mother Yashoda organizes how they should, what order they should walk.
他说到，Rama，就是巴拉Rama，你走在 Krishna 的前面，Shridam，Shridam，你和 Sarup 就走在 Krishna 的后面身后，所以亚瑟的妈妈就这样的，安排他们走的顺序。
And then she spoke to another cowherd boy named Amshu, and she said, you stay on Krishna's right, and Subhav, you're on his left.
他又对另外一个牧牛童说道，Amshu，你走在Krishna的右手，Subhav，你走在Krishna的左手。
So, usually the boys would just walk spontaneously and they would just walk as they liked. But Mother Yashoda, she wants to organize them, she wants to direct them, how they should walk, what order.
一般来说这些男孩子们他们都会尽兴的随性的走路，但是亚瑟的妈妈呢，她就想给他们组织起来。
And Mother Yashoda tells the boys, don't let Krishna go into the dangerous places, and shouldn't go where there are thorns, and try to protect him from the hot sun. And make sure Krishna eats a good lunch. Make sure he takes his lunch properly. So Mother Yashoda, she finished all of her requests, and then she looks at Krishna's face, and she gets Krishna to promise, and gets the other boys also, that they will do what she said.
亚瑟的妈妈说完这番话之后呢，提出了这些要求，他就看着Krishna的脸，就让Krishna向他做出保证，他也让其他的那些牧牛童，也向他纷纷做出保证。So
this way, Mother Yashoda, she showed more love than a cow who had just given birth to a calf, that her love for Krishna is greater than that.
此时此刻，亚瑟的妈妈对Krishna展示的爱，甚至超越了一个刚生下小牛的母牛对她的牛犊展示的爱。换句话说，亚瑟的妈妈的爱甚至比母牛的爱。
So Krishna bowed down to his mother and held her feet, and then he embraced her, and then finally, with great effort, he made her turn back so that Krishna can go into the forest.
此时此刻，Krishna就朝他的母亲顶拜，就触碰了母亲的足。
Krishna wanted to convince his mother that he was serious to follow her instructions.
Krishna 希望说服自己的母亲，让她确信自己可以认真地遵守她的教导。
And he tells his mother that you have to eat your breakfast and you have many things to do at home. But that didn't convince her, but Krishna himself had to tell her, you have to go. You can't come with us into the forest.
妈说服他的母亲，但是 Krishna 就告诉他妈妈说，你不能跟我们一块儿去森林。
Mother Yashoda is crying and milk is dripping from her breast and she's standing there, she can't move.
Yashoda 妈妈就哭泣了起来，母乳呢就从她的胸口流淌滴到地上，她就呆呆地站在那里，一动都不动。
But the gopis, Mother Yashoda, she stayed there in one place, but the gopis, they kept following Krishna. And they were, their throats were choked. They were also crying. They couldn't sing any longer. They couldn't see even because so many tears in their eyes.
Yashoda 妈妈站在那里无法移动，可是 gopi 们，牧牛姑娘们还尾随着 Krishna。他们的喉咙梗塞，然后他们在眼里含着泪水，他们此时已经没办法继续的歌唱，因为他们的泪水模糊了他们双眼，他们也无法，也看不清前面的视线。
So the gopis couldn't hide their feelings. They were feeling so much sorrow and separation from Krishna. They couldn't hide it. They couldn't control their emotions.
此时呢，牧牛姑娘们，她们已经没办法再掩饰她们的情感了，因为要马上跟 Krishna 分开了，她们内心就越来越感到痛苦，她们再也没办法遮掩她们的感情。
So the gopis, they have even more stronger feelings than Mother Yashoda. They're the greatest devotees of Krishna.
牧牛姑娘们对 Krishna 的深情厚谊是最伟大的，她们甚至超越了Yashoda 妈妈，她们是 Krishna 最了不起的奉献者们。
And the gopis, they have wonderful qualities, like they're very shy, and they're also afraid of what the elders will be thinking about them.
这些牧牛姑娘们，她们全是拥有最优秀的品质，比如说羞涩，但她们也担心，她们有点惧怕长辈们会怎么看她们。
And they've gone out of the village without permission. So that's not, the young girls are not supposed to do that. In the village, the gopis could counteract the separation from Krishna by embracing Krishna. But now he's leaving them, they cannot do anything.
这些牧牛姑娘，她们在自己的村子里，她们因为能够跟 Krishna 拥抱，所以就能够抵消她们跟 Krishna 的这个分离的感情。但是现在呢，因为 Krishna 要马上就要走出村子了，他们就没办法这样去做。
And the gopis can't tell anybody what's wrong with them. They can't reveal their minds to people because they're just young girls and they're not married, so it's not proper that they have so much love for a young man.
Gopi 们呢，这些 Gopi 们呢，他们也没办法跟别人分享他们内心的感受，吐露他们的心声，因为他们都还是未婚少女，而他们却对一个年轻的小男孩子内心有着这么多的爱。
So Krishna had stolen the hearts of the gopis, and the gopis had come all the way out of the village. They were following Krishna into the forest.But then Krishna stopped him and he told them, you have to go back to your home.
Krishna 已经偷走了所有牧牛姑娘的心。牧牛姑娘们，她们纷纷的尾随着 Krishna， 也都离开了村子。但是 Krishna 就告诉他们，阻止了他们，告诉他们要命令他们回家。
And Krishna, by different facial expressions, by moving his eyebrows certain way, he wanted to make the girls a little afraid of him, that he's not pleased with them. And this way he forced them to stop.
Krishna 就做出了不同的表情，他的眉毛，他就挑动着自己的眉毛，让这些小姑娘们，内心的产生了对他的畏惧，知道 Krishna 对他们这样的做法并不高兴，他就以这种方式强迫牧牛姑娘们停止他们的脚步。
And the gopis also, then they stopped, they became motionless, just like Mother Yashoda, they were just standing in one place.
牧牛姑娘们，她们不得已就停下了脚步，一动不动的呆呆的站在那里，就像雅舍的妈妈一样。
Because Krishna had come, he was just on the edge of the forest, and the forest is not very safe for young girls, so Krishna didn't want them to come in the forest.
因为他们已经来到了森林的边上，对于年轻的小姑娘来说，进入森林是非常不安全的。Krishna 不希望他们跟他们一起走进森林。
And Krishna sent one of the cowherd boys to go and tell them, "Don't come any further. Now you have to go back."
Krishna 派一个牧牛童。告诉牧牛姑娘们，不要再继续前进了，现在你们得回村子了。
And Krishna shook his head and did different gestures to let them know he didn't want them to come any further.
Krishna 就摇了他的头，做了一些动作。表明他不希望牧牛姑娘这些小姑娘们再往前走了。
So Krishna and Mother Yashoda, rather the gopis and Mother Yashoda, they both in this one place, and they're all standing there crying in separation from Krishna.
Gopi 们和亚修的妈妈，他们就这样呆呆地站在一个地方。流着眼泪哭泣着，因为跟 Krishna 的分离，内心非常难过。
So Nanda Maharaj, he also loves Krishna, but when he sees his wife, when he sees Mother Yashoda's love for Krishna, he is overwhelmed. Wow, she's so attached to her son.
Nanda Maharaj 也深爱着 Krishna， 但是他看到自己的妻子对 Krishna 的爱是如此的巨大，他被深深的感动了。他妻子这么依恋他儿子。
So Nanda Maharaj also followed Krishna quite a distance, and different cowherd men also came with him.
追随着 Krishna 走了很远的距离，还有一些牧牛郎也跟着走了很远的距离。
And all the people of Braja, all the people of Vrindavan, they all had so much love for Krishna. When Nanda Maharaj saw that they all love Krishna so much, he also was not able to turn back. He didn't want to leave Krishna.
Braja 的居民们，所有 Vrindavan 的居民们都深爱着 Krishna。当 Nanda Maharaj 看到他们如此的爱 Krishna， 他也不想回家，不想离开 Krishna。
So Nanda Maharaj, he's the head, he's the king of the cowherd people. So he was always surrounded, there were many people around him, like the brahmanas and the priests and the different Brijbasi people. He was always involved with many different issues.
Nanda Maharaj is the head of the cowherd. 他身边呢就簇拥着一大群人，有婆罗门和祭司，还有Brajavasi，他们都还有各自的事务。But
even though Nanda Maharaj had all these people with him, he wasn't able to leave Krishna. He wants to keep going with Krishna.
即便Nanda Maharaj 和这些人在一起。
Okay, we will just stop here.
我们讲课部分就停下来。接下来我们回答问题。
Yeah, any questions?
OPPO这一手机顶拜Guru和老师们，这是一个佛法师兄的提问。如果我在佛法里通过各种修行已经获得了一定的证悟和跟随者，是否也必须要按照八训规的教导，从当下的位置上退回到奉爱服务，才能走上Krishna知觉这条道路？
This devotee have several questions. The first one is obeisance to guru and teachers. This question is raised by a Buddhist god brother. If I, by practicing Buddhism, I have attained a certain level of realization and also have some followers, should I also follow the Sheikh Shastaka, the teaching of Sheikh Shastaka, and from my present position, return back to the devotional service so that I can step on the path of Krishna consciousness?
Yes.
是的。
Step on the path of Krishna consciousness. That's the right thing to do.
走上 Krishna 知觉这条道路是正确的道路.
Because on the other path, on your Buddhist path, you're not giving them the shelter of Krishna.
因为在您的佛教的道路是不能给予他们。
So there's no shelter there. It's just the material world.
那里没有庇护，只有物质世界。
So better you show them the example and take them to the higher path, Krishna consciousness.
所以您最好给他们做出榜样，向他们展示有更高的。 道路，那就是Krishna知觉了。
Follow the Shikshastika.
要遵守八训规。
The Shikshastika is the essence of all of the philosophy of Krishna consciousness. Everything is there within the Shikshastika prayers.
八训规是核心，是Krishna知觉哲学的核心，一切呢都浓缩在。
So you have to begin by chanting the holy name. You have to chant the Hare Krishna mantra. It's very important. And you have to want to try to please Krishna. Remember, Krishna consciousness is about pleasing Krishna.
需要唱诵圣名，念诵 Hare Krishna mantra， 这是非常重要的，要取悦 Krishna。 取悦 Krishna， 在 Krishna 的知觉当中呢，取悦 Krishna 是至关重要的。
Yes.
So next part of the question is that 从您学生那里了解到，您是一位真正以苦行、谦卑、仁慈、践行真理的瑜伽圣人，所以我特别想请教您，像我这样一个也是把生命交给探寻真理的修行人，应该如何才能放下这么根深蒂固对假我、假相的执着，让自己能超越二元性的影响，转向真正的真理呢？ For your student, I know that you are genuine sadhu, yogic sadhu. You have a penance, the quality of penance, humbleness, and mercifulness, and you have practiced the path of truth. Therefore, I especially want to inquire from you. So I myself is also a practitioner who have given my life to the path of the truth, to explore the truth. So how can I also give up the attachment, the deep rooted attachment to the false ego, to the illusion, to transcend the influence of duality and turn to the truth, the genuine truth. Gratitude to you.
Well, you have to follow the process of devotional service. It begins by associating with devotees who practice Krishna consciousness.
你要追随奉爱服务的方法，和那些修行 Krishna 知觉的人们联谊。
You have to learn how to practice the different principles of Krishna consciousness through the association of devotees. You have to hear and chant about Krishna, and you have to engage your senses in the service of Krishna.
你需要学习，学习怎样修行，就是 Krishna 知觉的这些原则。通过奉献者的联谊来去践行 Krishna 知觉的原则，去将自己的感官从事于服务 Krishna、聆听和唱诵 Krishna。
Because you've already done spiritual practice, you've already been engaging in some spiritual practice, so you have detachment from the material, but you have no realization of the spiritual.
因为您已经进行了灵修，所以对物质有着弃绝心，但是还没有觉悟到什么是灵性。
So this developing attachment for the spiritual comes by hearing and chanting about Krishna.
如何发展对灵性的依附呢？是通过聆听唱诵 Krishna。
You have cultivated the knowledge of the miseries of the material world. You know the nature of the materialistic life, and you're not drawn to it, you're not attracted to it. That's good.
你已经培养了就是物质世界是非常痛苦的这方面的知识，并且了解了物质世界的本性。
But you have to come.
这个没有被物质世界吸引，这非常好。
But you have to cultivate some knowledge of the spiritual now. You have to develop your attraction towards the spiritual energy. You have to understand there's a spiritual potency, and that comes from Krishna, and you have to hear and chant about Krishna.
但是您必须现在要培养灵性的知识，发展对灵性能量的依附，明白去了解灵性的能量，这些来自于 Krishna。您要聆听和唱诵 Krishna。
So you have to begin by studying carefully the Bhagavad Gita. And studying the Bhagavad Gita means you have to discuss it in the association of devotees.
你要开始研习博伽梵歌，学习和讨论博伽梵歌，这意味着要在奉献者的联谊之中学习和讨论博伽梵歌。
Then we have the higher study, the Srimad Bhagavatam, which is a very big volume and with many slokas and covers many topics. And it's a very important book which we give a lot of time and we put a lot of energy into discussing and understanding these texts.
之后我们还有更高的要学习的内容，那就是《念佛家版刊》，它有很多卷，然后里面有很多的诗节，有涉及了很多的主题，然后这本书是非常重要的，需要花很多的时间和很多的精力来讨论并且明白这些经文。
So you want to find out the devotees and you want to try to get as much association as you can from them, be in their association regularly, hearing and chanting.
所以您应该尽可能的去找奉献者，尽可能的和奉献者们联谊，有规律的在他们联谊当中聆听和唱诵。
Now because you've already been doing some practice of spiritual life,There will be many philosophical differences. Things will be different from what you were thinking before you contacted Krishna consciousness.
因为这以前呢，您已经做过灵修了，所以就有很多不同的哲学思想，有很多的其他的想法，跟 Krishna 这些不同。
So you have to be willing to hear carefully and you have to try to just bring out your doubts and discuss and we will try to explain and enlighten you.
您需要小心翼翼地去聆听，您也心中的疑惑可以尽可能地提出来，我们可以讨论并且向您解释，启发您。
Yes. Okay. Is there still a question? How you went, Tima?
The next one?
Yeah.
下一个来自于下一个是Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj Kirti Devadasi Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj Devotees Please accept my humble obeisances All glories to Srila Prabhupada It happens that when we achieve some kind of stability in the service We perform the same actions For example, daily worship of the deities at home We begin to do it mechanically How to avoid it? Kirti Devadasi
How you have to translate to Chinese?
Okay, 这个下一个问题是来自于 Kirti 的 Devadasi 的 Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj 奉献者们，请接受我谦卑的顶拜，所有荣耀归于 Srila Prabhupada。就是问题是，当我们在已经在服务当中，已经从事了稳定的服务，我们会。做一些活动，比如说在家中每天崇拜神像，我们就开始机械的去崇拜神像了。如何能避免呢？
by chanting the holy name and hearing about Krishna.
通过唱诵圣名，聆听 Krishna。
As you do your service, as you engage in the deity worship, at that time also you should chant the holy name.
在您做服务的过程当中和崇拜神像的过程当中，要一同的唱诵圣名。
We'll remind you that Krishna is a person.
这会让您想起 Krishna 是一个人。
And you're doing service for a person. It's not just something. You're not just serving a picture or a statue, but he's a person.
而不是服务一张照片或者是一尊雕像，他是一个人。
Okay, 下一个问题。
下一个是 Yuna, Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj.Leaks us some humble businesses. When we come to Krishna consciousness, we can stop enjoying material pleasure, but it's very difficult to stop suffering from material problems. Why is this happening? We enjoy. We enjoy it because of attachments, and we suffer because of attachments. Why in Krishna consciousness the pleasure?Of attachment is the first to disappear, but the suffering cannot be eliminated. Thank you. 下一个问题是来自于 Yuna Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj， 请接受我卑微的顶拜。当我们来到 Krishna 之觉的时候，我们可以停止享受物质的快乐，但是很难阻止物质的痛苦，物质问题带来的痛苦，为什么会有这种事情发生呢？我们是享受，因为依附我们去享受，而我们受苦是因为，也是因为依附。但是为什么在 Krishna 的知觉当中，依附的快乐是第一个消失的，依附带来的快乐是第一个消失的，但是。痛苦却无法被清除呢？感恩您。
Well, this may be only your own realization. I've never seen described anything like this in the scriptures.
这也许是您自己的觉悟，我从来没看到经典当中是这样描述的。
Happiness and distress.Are opposite sides of the same coin.
快乐和痛苦是一枚硬币的，就是两面。
We have to learn to tolerate happiness and distress.
要学会容忍苦乐。
You say the happiness goes first. That our attack, we lose the happiness, right? What was it?
Yes.
We lose the happiness. The first thing we do is to lose, but the distress goes only after a long time. It's because the material world is a place of distress.
您说就是为什么对物质享乐的依恋是第一个消失的，然后物质的问题带来的痛苦却不走呢？物质世界本身它就是一个痛苦之地。
Actually, there's only illusion of pleasure. There is no real pleasure here in the material world. It's all suffering.
实际上呢，快乐只是一种幻觉，在物质世界没有快乐，全部都是痛苦。
Bhagavad Gita says, "Dukala yama shashvatam." This material world, from the highest planet.Brahma down to the lowest are all places of misery.
佛教梵歌就说了 ，Dukkalayama Shasvata， 从物质世界最高的星球 Brahma 的星球到最低的星宿，全都是痛苦短暂之地。
Jiva Goswami gives the example. He said, "Material life is just like being in a salt mine."There's only one taste, salt.
Shiva Goswami 说到，在物质世界就好像一口盐井、盐矿，在一个盐矿里只有一个味道，就是咸味儿。
So material life, there is only suffering, but there's a little illusion of happiness, very small amounts of happiness. So very quickly that happiness disappears, goes.
So the material world, it has only a little bit of suffering, and only a little bit of happiness. And this little bit of happiness will be very quickly disappeared.
下一个问题。
下一个问题。这来自一个手机号。另外，再请教咕噜一个问题：我自己可能习惯了天马行空、自由自在的生活，在 Krishna 知觉的服务中，也喜欢选择性的只做自己喜欢、擅长的事情。如果感觉有被安排、被限制的地方，心里会不舒服，很抵抗。请问在 Krishna 知觉里，是否允许这样的个体性继续存在呢？还是必须要磨掉这样的韧性和自由呢？感恩你。I want to inquire from Guru another question. I have accustomed to the life of easy and free life.I want to do things like a horse in the sky, very carefree life. Yet in Krishna consciousness, during the service, I also want to select those things I choose to do what I like and expert to do. If I feel, as soon as I feel,I'm conditioned, I'm being arranged, I feel uncomfortable in the heart, there will be feeling of rejection. My question is that in Krishna consciousness, is it allowed this kind of individuality to continue to exist? Or I have to get rid of this whimsicalness and this freedom. Thank you.
Yes, you have to get rid of this whimsical nature. You think you're free, actually you're not free. You're just controlled by your mind and senses.
是的，您必须要磨掉这样的韧性和自由。您自以为是自由自在的，但实际上是被自己的感官、被自己的心意所控制着的。
If you want to really transcend the material energy, you have to surrender to Krishna.
如果您真想超越物质能量，必须要向 Krishna 臣服。
You have to take shelter of the spiritual energy.Through the pure devotees, you have to have a spiritual master, you have to take instruction from him, you have to follow. You should not be independent.
您必须要向灵性能量臣服，脱避于灵性的能量，要透过纯粹的奉献者来脱避于灵性的能量。您应当有灵性导师来接受灵性导师的训示，之后去追随这些训示，而不能自由自在的任意妄为。
Acting independently and whimsically is not encouraged in Krishna consciousness.
独立行事和肆意妄为、任意妄为。任性在 Krishna 知觉当中是不被允许的。
You're not going to progress. You're not going to make any advancement.
这样子任性和这种任性和自由是不能取得进步的。
下一个问题。
下一个问题。Hare 这来自于 HP， Hare Krishna 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 和所有奉献者，应该如何怀着亚瑟的妈妈和牧牛姑娘的心态服务 Krishna 呢？这种服务的心态是来自于聆听经典的知识，还是单一的奉爱服务呢？ Hare Krishna blessings to Guru Maharaj and all devotees. How can I serve Krishna in the mood of Yashoda mother and the gopis? Is this kind of mood come from hearing Shastra or through single devotional service? Single devotional service.
You have to hear Shastra.
你必须要聆听经典。
At the same time, you also have to perform devotional service.
与此同时还要履行做奉献服务。
You have to be guided by Sadhu, Shastra, and Guru.
你必须得到Sadhu, 圣人 Shastra, 经典和 Guru, 领导师的指导。
Ideally,There should be somebody else, some senior Vaishnava who is also cultivating the similar mood of Mother Yashoda, and they should guide you.
理想的状态是，应该有另外就是别的年长奉献者，他们也在培养着Yashoda妈妈的心态，她能够指导别人。
So you should be guided by your spiritual master, who.Can help you, who can guide you properly.
您当得到您的灵性导师的指导，灵导师可以正确的指导您。
Usually, we encourage devotees don't try to jump up to exalted to very high things. First, try to be the servant of Krishna.
通常我们不鼓励奉献者一下子跳到。很高的境界，首先努力做 Krishna 的仆人。
To become Krishna's mother, you have to first you become a good servant and become very fixed and steady in your practice of devotional service.
要想做，就是以 Krishna 母亲的心态。拥有这种心态，首先第一步，先作为一个好仆人。您的奉献服务是专一的、稳定的、非常坚定的服务。
And then here, from the scriptures, and then you can try to follow in the footsteps of Mother Yashoda.
然后聆听。努力地追随亚修的妈妈的步伐。下一个问题。来自于Sambanda Das。今天的课中看到对 Krishna 的爱，是否只有个体灵魂与 Krishna 之间才会有这种爱？个体灵魂之间有这种爱吗？爱只能在个体灵魂与 Krishna 之间才会有吗？ So in this lecture, we can see the love to Krishna. My question is that, is this kind of love only exist between individual soul and Krishna? Will there be this kind of love between individual souls? Is this kind of love only exist between Jiva and Krishna?
Yes, it's there between the Jiva and Krishna, but those souls who are pure devotees of Krishna, who are very dear to Krishna, then we can also have love for these souls.
是的，在个体灵魂和 Krishna 之间拥有这种爱。但是那些灵魂，他们已经是纯粹的奉献者，并且是对 Krishna 来说是非常亲切的。这些灵魂之间也可以拥有这种爱。
If, just like Krishna has his cowherd boyfriends, So the cowherd boys, they all love Krishna, but they also love each other. They're also caring and concerned about each other, but naturally they have the greatest love for Krishna.
我们看到Krishna的牧牛同朋友，他们是多么爱Krishna，但是他们彼此之间也互相关心、互相爱护，但是他们对Krishna是怀着最伟大的、最了不起的爱。
And Krishna's devotees, actually, they're just like Krishna. Because they're completely surrendered to Krishna, so the devotee is happy. The devotee wants to give everything for the service of Krishna's devotees. And you please Krishna by pleasing his devotees.
Krishna奉献者就像Krishna一样，因为他们完全臣服了Krishna。 奉献者就想给Krishna最大的快乐，也想给Krishna奉献者最大的快乐。通常你取悦了Krishna的奉献者，就会取悦Krishna。Krishna
is in the hearts of all of his devotees. And when the devotees are serving Krishna or serving Krishna's devotees, they can perceive Krishna in the heart of the devotees.
Krishna在全体奉献者的内心，奉献者们他们在服务Krishna，服务奉献者的过程当中，他们觉悟到Krishna就在奉献者们的内心。
Just like we say, one who is Krishna's devotee, he's not really Krishna's devotee. But one who is the devotee of Krishna's devotee, he is my devotee. So Krishna takes special interest in those who are devotees to his, who are devoted to his devotees.
据说，就是谁要说他是Krishna的奉献者，他不是真正的奉献者。但是，如果他是Krishna的奉献者的奉献者，他是真正的奉献者。Krishna就对那些他的奉献者的奉献者产生特殊的兴趣。
Yes.
下一个问题是来自于 Pushpa Sara Devadasi. 顶拜 Gurudev， 顶拜所有的奉献者，请问 Gurudev， 物质躯体是 Krishna 的碎片部分，也是 Krishna 的一部分，为什么我们不能依恋家人，而只依恋 Krishna？ 感恩您 ，Hare Krishna. Obeisance to Gurudev. Obeisance to all devotees. Questions that, Gurudev. Although the material body is The material bodies are parts of Krishna. Why can't we attach our family members? We can only attach to Krishna. Thank you, Hare Krishna.
Well, the problem is when we think of our family members, we're thinking of the body. We're not thinking of the soul. The soul is a part and parcel of Krishna. But when we think of our family members, we're only thinking of the body relationship. We're not thinking of the soul.
问题是我们一想到家人的时候，只会想到家人的躯体，而不是想到家人的灵魂。灵魂是Krishna的碎片部分。问题是我们一想到家人的时候， 就联想到他们的躯体，而不是想到他们的灵魂。
all living entities are part and parcel of Krishna. So we should think of everyone in all the different life, the forms of life, as part of, as being our family members. Don't just think only in terms of the bodily family members.
所有的生物体都是Krishna的碎片部分，在所有的生命种族、各种各样生命形式当中的生物体，全部都是我们的家人，不要只是想着，家人的躯体是我们的家人。
These family relationships are very temporary. Before you were born, they were not your family members. And after we leave this body, they won't be our family members anymore.
这些家庭关系是非常短暂的。在我们出生之前呢，他们并不是我们的家人。而在我们离开躯体之后呢，他们也不再是我们的家人了。But
we're thinking so much the body. We're attached to the body, we're attached to these designations. Who is the father? Who is the mother? Krishna is the real father.
但是我们只是在想着躯体，依附着他们的躯体，依附着这些头衔儿，谁是父亲，谁是母亲呢？ Krishna 是父亲， Krishna 是母亲。
So, if we're attached to the body, that's like the cow who's attached to her calf. That's like the animals.
如果我们依恋的是躯体的话，那就像母牛依恋它的小牛犊，那就像动物一样。It's
not intelligent. You have to understand there's a soul within the body. And the attachment should be based on the soul.
这种做法就不是有智慧的，要明白，在躯体当中存在着灵魂，依恋的应当是灵魂。下一个问题是来自于 Varadai Shwar Devadasi。 请接受我谦卑的顶拜，请问Gurudev，我在修习 Krishna 之觉中做奉爱服务时，例如给奉献者做念珠袋送给他们，但他们觉得我做的不够好，那我以后还做这项服务吗？ Please accept my humble obeisance. Gurudev, during the practice of Krishna consciousness, during the service, for example, I will make a japa. Manufacture them and send them as gift to devotees, but the devotee felt it's not good enough. So in the future, will I also continue the service?
Well, I'd like to know why they say it's not good enough. Is it they don't like the design of your bead bag? That you're maybe your handicraft work is not good enough. Maybe you didn't design the bead bag nicely. I don't know. But it's nice that you're thinking about you want to please the devotees. That's good. So inquire from the devotees what you can do to improve and how to please them.
So you want to please the devotees. This attitude is very good. You can ask the devotees why it's not good. What places need to improve? 怎么才能取悦奉献者呢?
There's always nice service to be done. We always need people who are willing to serve. So it's good you have a mood to want to do service. It's very nice. We just need to find the right service for you.
So my question is that the pan that Krishna eat, is it from the spiritual world or a kind of fruit?
Well,
because
what?
Because in Hainan Island, China, there is kind of pan that as soon as one eat it, the teeth will become red and face become red and one will become intoxicated, like drinking liquor. So it about the issue of pan, is that the devotees can eat then?
No, devotees don't eat pan.
奉献者不吃槟榔.
But we offer it to Krishna.
但是我们供奉给 Krishna.
Krishna likes pan, but we don't ourselves take the pan.
Krishna 喜爱槟榔, 但是我们自己不吃槟榔.
Some temples, they prepare pan and they offer it to the deity of Krishna. And then after it's offered to the deity of Krishna, then they will give it to some people who are not initiated devotees, who are not practicing strictly.
有些庙宇 给 Krishna 的神像供奉槟榔, 在供奉之后呢, 他们就会派发给那些没有启迪的奉献者, 不严格遵守规范原则的奉献者。
But you're right, when you chew it, it's red, and your teeth go all red, and it's an intoxicant, it's a mild intoxicant, it's true.
您说的很正确, 吃了之后牙齿变红, 脸变红, 然后呢, 会醉。
But Krishna enjoys it, so we offer it to Krishna.
但是 Krishna 特别喜欢吃槟榔, 我们呢, 就供奉给 Krishna 吃。
Yes, 下一个问题。
下一个问题是来自于 仆人, 顶拜咕噜。 我们想要培养起牧牛姑娘对 Krishna 的爱, 请问结婚的也可以达到这种情感吗? Obeisance to Guru, we want to cultivate that kind of love that the gopis have to Krishna. A question that the married, after marriage, can we also attain this kind of emotion?
Yes, gopis are married.
可以, 因为牧牛姑娘们, 她们也是结了婚的。
So you can love Krishna. You can love Krishna just as the gopis love Krishna.
您可以爱 Krishna, 就像牧牛姑娘那么爱 Krishna 那样爱 Krishna。
Just don't let your husband know.
不要让你的丈夫知道。
Keep it a secret from your husband.
要保密，保守秘密，不要让你的丈夫知道这份秘密。
Just like if you have another lover, a secret lover, you don't want your husband to know.
就好像 像你有一个秘密的恋人，你就不要让你的丈夫知道这份恋情。
So you be a good wife and serve your husband nicely, and within your heart you serve Krishna.
您做一个好妻子，好好的服侍您的丈夫，但是在内心，服务 Krishna。
Yes, 下一个问题。
下一个是来自于 Novel 这一个手机。顶拜 Guru Dev 莲花组身体有病也是消除业报吗？ Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. Is the illness from the body is also eliminating our karma?
Eliminating our karma.
If we have some disease, so is this kind of suffering is also...
Yes.You're right. This is our karma. Yes. So the disease, it's a sign of our karma, and our karma is being reduced by the disease.
是的，您是对的。这个疾病是我们的业报。那我们身体患了疾病，这就是在消除我们的业力。The next one?
Yeah.
Radhananda Devadasi, 深深顶拜敬爱的圣姑 Maharaj, 在物质世界待了太久了，物质惯性随时因为我们不好的品性就断开我们和 Krishna 的连接，请问 Guru Maharaj 在离开躯体时，如果遇到这样的断开，我们还能得到拯救吗？ Please accept my obeisance, deep obeisance, dear Guru Maharaj, because we haveStaying in the material world for such a long time. Our material habits can disconnect our relationship with Krishna, can cut our attachment. So these bad qualities can cut our connection with Krishna at any time.So my question is that Guru Maharaj, while we're leaving the body, if there is that kind of disconnection, can we get salvation?
Well, if we have been using our body in the service of Krishna throughout our life, even if at the time of death we're not able to remember Krishna, Krishna will remember us.
如果我们在一生当中就利用我们的善用躯体来服务 Krishna 的话，即便在死亡之际想不起 Krishna， Krishna 会想着我们。
Krishna will not forget his devotees. Anybody who has done service for him, then certainly Krishna will deliver him.
Krishna 不会忘记他的奉献者，任何为 Krishna 做过服务的人。Krishna 肯定会拯救他的。
It's not just only the moment of death.
所以，就是问题不是只是在死亡那一刻的问题。
So even at the moment of death, somehow we may die. For some reason we may not be able to think of Krishna at the time of death.But Krishna will remember us.
在死亡之际呢，如果我们想不起 Krishna 的话 ，Krishna 也会记着我们的，想着我们。
But you have to have dedicated your life to Krishna, that you've given your life to Krishna.
但是您必须把一生呢，要把一生的生命都献给 Krishna。献给 Krishna。
还有问题？
还有，于海棠，顶拜 Guru， 我是新奉献者。念诵的时候，我念的是 Hare Krishna， 听帕帕的爷爷的音频，感觉他念的是 Hare Krishna。Hare 和 Hare 有什么区别吗？还是都可以呢
Yeah, don't worry about the pronunciation so much. The important thing is your mood, that you're calling to Krishna, and Hare is Krishna's energy.
不要太过于纠结这个发音，重要的是心态。您在呼唤着 Krishna， Hare 是能量。
Hare is coming from the word Hara, and Hara is Krishna's spiritual potency, personified by Radharani.
哈瑞这个词来自于 Hara， Hara 是 Krishna 的灵性能量，它是 Radharani 就是 Krishna 的灵性能量的化身。
So we're chanting Hare Krishna is not different from chanting Radha Krishna.
我们唱诵 Hare Krishna 和唱诵 Radha Krishna 没有区分。
So our mood is to chant with love, that we're like a child and Krishna is like they're like our Father, Krishna, Radha Krishna, like our parents, we're like the child, we're separated from Krishna. We want to go back to be with Krishna.
我们念诵的时候，怀着孩子一般爱父母一般的爱，Krishna就是我们的父亲，Radha就像我们的母亲。 所以我们现在是跟 Krishna 分开了，我们希望回到 Krishna 那里和 Krishna 在一起。So
the important point is to chant with love, and of course we want to hear the holy name. So we hear Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Next one from HP Hare Krishna 顶拜女生马尔林阿祖， 因为我还没有脱离guru， 请马尔林圣门徒标准是什么呢？ Hare Krishna basins Mara to your lotus feet. I haven't taken shelter yet. So Mara, what's the standard for you to accept disciple?
Well, standard is that you're supposed to be recommended by someone who is like an authority. Wherever you're attending programs, they're like the authority. So they can recommend you. You should be attending a regular program. You should be part of a group, and you meet regularly and you discuss the philosophy.
你要有规律的参加当地的活动，您需要有一个固定的小组，定期的参加联谊，讨论哲学。
It's important that you can get along with the devotees.
很重要的一点就是需要跟奉献者相处融洽，很好的关系。
If we cannot have good relationships with the devotees, then it will be very difficult to practice Krishna consciousness.
如果不能跟奉献者之间建立 融洽的良好关系很难修习 Krishna 之觉。
So you have to be attending something, some kind of meeting regularly that you may not be able to physically attend, but at least you should attend maybe online.
那您要定期的参加，就是碰头会，也可能不能亲身的跟奉献者们在一起联谊，但是至少要在线上有这种定期的联谊。
But just attending online is not as good as actually being physically present.
但是仅仅是在线上的联谊是这个效果是没办法跟亲身联谊相比的。
So,In order to be recommended for initiation, you have to be strictly following the four principles and you have to be chanting 16 rounds for a minimum of 6 months and ideally for 1 year.
为了得到推荐获得启迪，您就要遵守四项规范原则，最少念诵16圈，而且呢，念诵16圈的时间是最少要6个月以上，理想的状态是念了一年。
And you should have also taken part in the ISKCON disciple course.
您需要去参加 ISKCON 的就是门徒课程。
The disciple course is very helpful for us to understand the duty of a disciple and how to go about getting initiation.
这个门徒课程就帮助我们了解门徒的职责是什么，并且了解启迪的程序。
嗯哼。
下一个问题。下一个问题是来自于 Tulasi， 请问 Guru， 必须要念 Gayatri Mantra 才能揭示自己在灵性世界灵用身份吗？Guru, my question is that only by chanting Gayatri Mantra can reveal our spiritual identity in the spiritual world?
No. Not true. Not true. By chanting Hare Krishna, you can understand your spiritual identity.
If you chant Hare Krishna, you can understand your spiritual identity.
下一个问题。
下一个问题来自于这一个匿名的顶拜古对圣顶博加瓦坛1.1.19世节要旨有这样一句话，不理解吗？所谓解脱的人，永远不会满足于只重复梵文 Aham Brahmasmi， 请古指教。Obeisance Guru's lotus feet, so I cannot understand the purport from Srimad Bhagavatam 1.1.19. It said that the so-called liberated person can never be satisfied by repeating Aham Brahmasmi at the Guru's instruction, guidance.
Yes.To just simply know I'm a soul will not satisfy a devotee because it doesn't tell us, it's not explaining clearly what is the duty of knowing that we're a soul.
仅仅是了解我们是灵魂是不能满足一个奉献者的，因为这没有告诉作为灵魂他的职责是什么。
We cannot just simply recite Aham Brahmasmi, Aham Brahmasmi. I am the soul, I am the soul. We have to know what is the duty of the soul. What function does a soul have? What is the relationship of the soul with the Supreme Soul? We have to understand higher knowledge.
只是重复 Aham Brahmasmi. 这是 不能揭示，不能揭示那灵魂的职责。那他的作为灵魂的功能是什么？他不能揭示灵魂和至尊灵魂之间的关系，他还需要有更高级的知识。
So it's good somebody knows they're not the body, they're the soul, but they have to go on. That's only the very beginning of spiritual life. Devotional service begins from this point.
那了解是灵魂也是好的，但是还需要继续提升。了解我们是灵魂，这只是做奉爱服务的开始而已。
下一个问题。
下一个是来自于王文言，顶拜 Guru， 请问 Guru， 今天讲述的 Krishna 消失光 ，Krishna 和牧牛姑娘的年龄分别是多大 ？Hare Krishna。Okay, this is Guru. So in today's lila about Krishna, what's the age for Krishna and the gopis separately? Hare Krishna.
What's the age of Krishna and the age of the gopis?
Yes.
Oh, well, Krishna's about 8 or 9. And gopis are younger.
Krishna 大概八九岁，然后那些牧牛姑娘呢，要比 Krishna 年轻。
下一个问题。
The next one is from Yamuna Tira, Dimbai Guru. 我们经常说 ，Yes, yes.
Guru Maharaj， 我们后面还有七八个问题呢。
七八个。
您的时间方便吗？
那可以啊。
可以是吧？
嗯。
太好了。好，那我们继续吧。
我们继续，仰慕的贴着这个问题，明白 Guru。我们常说 Guru Sadhu Sastra， 在这里 Guru 和 Sadhu 也就是灵性导师和圣人有什么不同呢？感恩。This is Guru. We often refer to Guru, Sadhu, etc. And Guru is the Sadhu. What's the difference between Guru and Sadhu? Thank you.
Well, Guru you have some relationship with. You're accepting him as your spiritual shelter. You're maybe taking instruction from him. He may be Diksha Guru, he may be Shiksha Guru. Sadhu is...some spiritual authority. You may not have connection with him.
Guru is you with him. You accepted his shelter. It may be the Shiksha Guru or the Chidi Guru. And a Sadhu is just a spiritual authority. It doesn't have any
connection. Sadhu can be also the previous Acharyas who.Appeared in this world long before us.
Sadhu 也可以指前辈、先辈 Acharya， 就在我们之前很久之前显现的。
嗯哼，下一个问题。
下一个是来自于这一串问题，这个匿名奉献者，还有一个也是圣念不掉的他1.1.19，这个世界的。Uttama Shloka 是指那些不导致无知的文献，不懂请教 Guru， 感恩 Guru， 感恩。This is continue with the previous question. Also from Srimad Bhagavatam 1.1.19, it is said that Uttama Shloka refers to those literature that.Don't lead to ignorance, cannot understand.
Well, Uttama Sloka refers to those words which glorify the Supreme Lord Krishna.
Uttama Sloka 是指的那些荣耀 Krishna 的话语。
Uttama means the topmost, so the perfection of all language is to use our words to glorify the Supreme Lord Krishna.
的意思是最高流的。那对于一个话语言语的完美，就是用言语来荣耀 Krishna。
And when Krishna is glorified, then there's no ignorance.
一旦 Krishna 被荣耀的时候，就不再无知，也就荡然无存了。
Okay.
下一个问题来自 Jaya. Hare Krishna, my obeisance unto you. Does it mean the relationship between living beings should be based on the relationship with Krishna?
Yes.
Hare Krishna,
Krishna should be the center of all relationships.
这个问题就是，生物体是生这个问题是，生物体之间的关系是不是也应该建立在他们和 Krishna 的关系基础之上呢？回答就是是的 ，Krishna 应该是我们所有关系的中心核心。
That is Krishna consciousness, to see everything in relation to Krishna.
这是 Krishna 之觉，是看到万事万物都跟 Krishna 有关系。
Yes, 下一个问题。
Yes, Varadeshvara replied that her feedback is not higher enough to the standard.
But then she needs to improve. She should try to improve to make it pleasing to the devotees.
如果不够标准的话，那就需要改进，来提升，来取悦奉献者们。
The Vedagamya in Vedagamya Mataji can make very nice feedbacks. Her shogong is very good.And she makes feedbacks regularly. She can teach you how to improve. You contact Vedagamya and have her train you how to improve your feedback.
就是，Vedagamya Mataji，她的手工特别的精湛。她呢会定期的做那个念珠袋儿，她可以训练您怎么改进您的手工。
You can contact Vedagamya through Sandini Mataji. She can connect you.
您找那个 Sandini Mataji， 然后让她给你联系 Vedagamya Mataji.
Yes. 下一个问题。
下一个问题来自于 Shruti Rupa Devadasi。另外再请教咕噜，小组乐意的时候，大家对荣耀不杀的唱歌跳舞别的不叫放歌感兴趣。但是对更多的学习就不喜欢了。请问咕噜，我们这样慢慢进步可以吗？您有什么训示吗？
They only like kirtan and prasadam.
Yes, they when they are happy in the association, they are only interested in prasadam, chanting and dancing and Bhagavad Gita, but no more interest in.Study, more no interest in more study. So can they make progress gradually, or are there any instructions from you?
Well,
thank you.
We have to every program. There has to be some time, a little time for transmission of spiritual knowledge. You have to, although they like kirtan, it's very good. They like prasadam, that's also very good, but they should hear a little.There should be some time spent reading, discussing the teaching from Bhagavad Gita.
就是需要有灵性知识的传递，除了 prasadam 之外，除了 kirtan 之外，那也是很好的。但是应当花一定的时间来讨论和教导佛教梵歌。Her question is that.Except Bhagavad Gita, there's no more, furthermore, interest in learning.
Okay, Bhagavad Gita and Hare Krishna, you do both, you can get perfection. don't have to do anymore.
可以，国家梵歌以及 Hare Krishna， 这两者做都去做，那么就不需要有更多的了。
Yes。
下一个问题来自于这一位手机，那个匿名的，顶拜敬爱的 Guru 和奉献者们，我从鹤岗来哈市陪 Krishna Das， 他刚刚参加工作，但我觉得一直雇人照顾卧床的老妈，我没尽到孝，都说服务主就不欠任何人的，这咋办呢？Krishna, blessings dear Gurudev and all devotees. I am from Hegang. I came to Hash, 不知道 to accompany Krishna Das. He had just had a job, but I felt very guilty because I cannot take care of my mother who is in her.Bed. She's ill and conditioned to the bed. It is said that by serving the Lord, we don't have any debt to anyone. But so what to do?
Sorry, it's...not very clear to me what the question is.
This devotee, she had, I guess her son is in another city, so she has to leave her mother, her mother, who is very ill and cannot get up from the bed.Need somebody to take care of, but this devotee has gone to another city to maybe take care of another devotee, a younger devotee, her son maybe, and so he felt very guilty, cannot take care of the elderly
mother. Yeah. So what's the question?
So.She felt very guilty, and it is said that if we serve Krishna, then there's no debt for anyone. But under such circumstances, so she is not sure what to do, what's the best way. Because she felt she is doing service, but yet she cannot take care of the mother.So she felt there's a dilemma.
Well, you have to decide. I can't decide this for you. You have to, there's so many so many issues, so many concerns, circumstances. I don't know everything about the situation. I cannot tell you what to do.You have to decide.
因为有很多的事情啊，有很多的考虑，方方面面的考虑，所以Guru他不知道您的具体情况，没办法告诉您，这个您得自己来做决策。
下一个问题。
The next one from 王文言，顶拜Guru，我是个修习 Krishna 不久的新人，而对 Krishna 想的相对少一点。这种情况需要我去有意的做调整吗 ？Hare Krishna. A business guru, I'm a new fighty. I practice Krishna not long, very long. So I, oh yes. 我平时总是能想到奉献者，对 Krishna 想的少。I always think about devotees, and I think Krishna not so frequently, but I think of devotee more frequently.So, under such circumstances, should I make the adjustment, Hare Krishna?
No, it's all right. By thinking of devotees, you will naturally come to think more about Krishna.
不需要调整，这是可以的，没问题的。通过想着奉献者，您逐渐的就会想着 Krishna 了，自然而然的。
But you should think about pure devotees. You shouldn't just think about any ordinary person. You should think about people who are pure devotees.
是您想的应该是纯粹的奉献者，而不是普通人。您来想着的那些纯粹了的奉献者们。
下一个问题。
下一个问题是来自于 Radhananda。Shows her gratitude to you for the reply. 下一个问题来自阿莲，牧牛姑娘对 Krishna 的爱是不是完美灵魂对 Krishna 的爱的榜样，普通生物的榜样吗？ So the gopi's love for Krishna, is it the example of love that is from pure those souls who have attained perfection, their love to Krishna. So are they showing example how a soul who has attained perfection, what kind of love can have to Krishna? So is this also example for the ordinary living entities?
Yes.We want to follow in the footsteps of the gopis. We want to develop love like the gopis for Krishna. Just as they love Krishna, we should try to follow their example.
是的，我们当追随这些 gopi 的榜样，发展出这些牧牛姑娘对 Krishna 的爱。他们是如此的爱 Krishna， 我们当追随他们的步伐。
But before we can come to that level, first of all, we have to become devotees ourselves.
但是当我们在达到他们的层面之前呢，我们应当自己成为奉献者。
We have to become very fixed and very steady in spiritual practice.
我们必须在我们自己的灵修应当是非常坚定的、稳定的。
We have to hear and chant for a long time before we can come to that level.
在我们达到他们这些层面的之前呢，我们要聆听唱诵很长时间。
下一个问题。
下一个问题来自于程真真，顶拜咕噜和奉献主持，顶拜所有的奉献者，顶拜您对这个物质世界的。所有感情关系都非常失望，以前认为感情关系就是最重要的，现在也接触到爱，爱非常重要，也意识到了知识是非常重要，爱和知识与物质情感关系是怎么一种联系呢？现在怎么慢慢转变这种心态呢？怎么从灵性角度认识这个问题呢？ A business guru, a business to host and all devotees.I'm very disappointed to the emotion and relationship in this material world. Formerly, I think that relationship and emotion is the most important. But now after contact, I feel that love is very important and knowledge is also very important. So what my question is that,What's the relationship between love and knowledge and that of the material emotion, a material relationship? So this is the first part.
Well, we have to understand material relationships are all based on the bodily platform and they're all temporary, but real love is eternal.And real love means to Krishna, not to the body, but to Krishna.
We need to know that material relationship is based on the body level, is short-term conscious. And love is eternal. Love is for Krishna, and not for the body. 爱是针对 Krishna 的。So how to transform, how to change this kind of mood gradually?
Yes, you have to do spiritual practice, you have to cultivate your spiritual knowledge by hearing and chanting, and you will understand you're a soul, and as you go on hearing and chanting, you will gradually develop attraction to Krishna, and that attraction becomes love. Real love means service, that you will do service for that person without any thought of anything in return. That is pure love.
真爱就是服务那个人，不想不祈求任何回报，这是纯粹的纯洁无瑕的爱。
Material relationships are all based on you satisfy my senses. We want somebody to do something to satisfy us, to make us happy. But real love is to make Krishna, to please Krishna.
物质的关系是建立在你得满足我的感官，是让别人满足，让别人满足自己的感官，让自己快乐。然而真正的爱是取悦 Krishna， 满足 Krishna。
下一个问题。
下一个问题。The third part of question is that how to.Understand this issue from the spiritual point of view. It's already answered.
Yeah.
下一个问题来自 Sati. Sorry, 对不起 Sati. 没了。下一个问题来自于 Panchabhattava Das said, Thank you for your mercy, dear Maharaj. 下一个是来自于一个手机。敬爱的 Guru, 奉献者叫Buddha Yanga, 这是什么意思呢? So this devotee is asked, Dear Maharaj Guru, so one devotee, her name is Buddha Yanga. What's the meaning for the name?
I don't know. Who gave her that name?
不知道是谁起的这个名字。
She should ask the person who gave her the name.
你可以去问起名字的谁起的名字问他。晕了。下个问题。So there are some normal questions, only some gratitude for you.
Okay, so Panchatattva, you can send that name, I can look at it, I don't know, maybe she spelt it wrong, maybe the pronunciation is not right. You can have him type it and send it to me in an email, I'll look at the name and try to figure out what the name is.
那这位 Vivo Y93 这个奉献者，你可以把这个 Udayanga 这个名字它的梵文的拼写，把它弄对，然后把用 email 发给咕噜，咕噜可以告诉你。
Okay, thank you very much. Well, my Ganshi Guru Manigi, well, my Gentai Defani, Ganshi Soi Defunctions of Ling Ting, Jufu Niman, Chang Song Bing Kwaila, Ganshi Asati Juja, Soi Defunctions of.祝福你们唱诵并快乐万事如意传教顺利是了 Prabhupada
好那外昆特之音服务员聆听 非常感谢敬爱的 Bhakti Vaishnava Vinashna Singha Swami 给我们带来精彩的大伯家晚堂甘露早课，感谢 Sati Mata 的主持，感谢所有奉献者的耐心聆听和提出的这些好问题。祝大家有一个 Krishna 直觉的一天。 Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna。